Good morning, children. Today we are going to continue the parts from that part till we had completed in our last class. So let's get a quick revision of what we have learned till now. In the chapter Brown Wolf, we have seen that the dog or wolf, whatever it is, it just comes from nowhere and comes to the cottage of Walt Irvine and Madge. And they try a lot to gain his confidence or to gain his love, but they were unable because the dog proved to be very unsociable. He did not let anybody come towards him, and then he tried to flee away from their house while he was better, while his condition was better. Actually, he had come to the house because he was famished and he was very weak. So the time when he became quite well to do, he started fleeing from the house. But every time he used to flee from the house, he would be returned back. Why? Because once it had happened, the first time when he had run away from the house, Walt had spotted him along the railway line, and then after bringing him home, he got a metal plate and he just tied it around the neck. So after that, that plate was always tied along with his neck, and he would be coming back every time he fled away from the house. Now we have also seen that whenever he used to run away from the house, the one thing which was very particular, which seemed very similar in case of his running out of the house, was that he always fled towards the north. Okay, he always run towards the north, and that is what Walt says, that it can be a kind of homing instinct. Okay, it can be a kind of feeling that he might have, that my home is towards this side. So after that, after a futile year of this trial of flying, fleeing again and again, he was unsuccessful. So later he decided that he's going to stay there now, but still it was a little difficult for them to get his love. But now he stayed, and so once a morning they went for a walk along the country road, and the dog was trailing behind. So they met a man on the way, and that turned out to be a person who was searching for his sister's house, and that person had come to surprise his sister. So he was searching for the way to the house. So Madge said that yes, you are just on the correct way, and within that time also he introduced himself as Skiff Miller. Okay, his name was Skiff Miller, and the his sister whom he was searching, that was Johnson, okay, Mrs. William Johnson. So they were having some conversation, and within that point we got to know that the dog came into view. Till now he was just back, okay, he was just in the behind, and he was just trailing over here and there. So now he had come to the view. Now let's see what happens. So Skiff Miller saw the dog, and a look of great wonder came into his face. And while Skiff Miller, the new person here, while he saw the dog, then a delight, the reaction was very wonderful. The reaction of the person was very wonderful. He was very happy to see the dog. "Well, well," he said slowly. At the sound of his voice, while he pronounced "well, well," so while the dog heard his voice, Wolf's ears flattened down and his mouth opened in a laugh. And this kind of reaction nobody had seen till now. And this was very because this thing was very different kind of a reaction, because this dog, which did not even let any person come towards him For Walt and Midge also, it became such a huge task to gain his love. After 1.5 years or something like that, they were now able to touch him, and only they. Now, this dog, looking at a stranger, his reaction was something else. He was very happy seeing Skiff Miller. And while he heard his voice, that was much more wonder to him. Wolf's ears flattened down and his mouth opened in a laugh. And this is a dog's reaction, okay? He opened his mouth as if he was laughing. He trotted up to the stranger. He moved up to the stranger and first smelled his hands, then licked them with his tongue. This is the first reaction of the dog when he sees Skiff Miller. Mark this paragraph 19, okay? This is important. So, when he just moved to the stranger, or you can say Skiff Miller, and after that he smelled his hands, then licked them with his tongue. This is the general, the general habit or behavior of a dog. They smell and then they start licking it while it seems very similar to them. Midge was amazed. We never saw Wolf make up to a stranger before. They were all amazed. They were all surprised. What is happening in front of our eyes? That this dog, whom we could not even touch at the first time, they took about a year or a half to get close to him. And here the dog itself is going to the stranger. That also at the very first time. How is this happening? Is that what you call him, Wolf? The man asked. And Skiff Miller asks that, is this the name that you call him by, or this animal by? He lifted one of Wolf's forelegs. That means the front leg. Okay, he just lifted it and examined the foot pads. Now, suppose this is the leg, so he just lifted it up and he checked the foot pad. Okay, this is called the foot pad. So he checked it and he started pressing it. He pressed it kind of soft, he remarked. He ain't been on trail for a long time. He has not gone out for a long time, right? He turned to Midge and Walt and asked, how long have you had him? And he questioned Walt and Midge that, since how long do you have him with you? But just then the dog, squirming and rubbing against the newcomer's legs, opened his mouth and barked. If you remember, then in the previous class we had discussed, he made a snarling sound. He also growled, okay? But that thing was it was definite that he had not barked. Nobody had heard him barking, yes? But this time, he started barking. Okay. Just then, the dog, while Skiff Miller just questioned to Walt and Midge that since how long are you having this animal with you? Just as that, the dog, who was squirming means going round and round against the person standing, and rubbing against the newcomer's leg. So if you have pets at your home, then you can imagine yourself that how they react, you know. Suppose I am the master, so if the pets love me, I am their master, so they love me very much, and they're always moving around me, and they're even rubbing their body also against my legs or whatever that is comfortable for them. And opened his mouth and barked, and he started barking. Walt and Midge stared at each other. They were like, what is happening? How is this possible? The miracle had happened. Mark this line again. Paragraph 24. The miracle had happened. Wolf had barked. Still they are calling him Wolf by the texture of his body. They are still calling him Wolf. It's the first time he ever barked, Midge said. Midge said that this is the first time we are hearing him barking. First time I ever heard him too, Miller added. Skiff Miller also confirmed this thing that yes, I am also listening this animal bark for the first time. Now, he was actually meaning that the dog was actually barking for the first time. But Mage was thinking that this person has just come now. If we have not heard, then how can he hear? So that's why he is saying that he is barking for the first time. Because within this much time, he is seeing him. But there is another meaning lying by. Let's see what's that. Mitch smiled at him. The man was evidently a humorist. Humorist means you have said something very, in a very funny way. But within that lies some hidden meaning. Okay, that is called sort of humorist. Mage smiled at him. The man was evidently a humorist. Of course, she said, since you have only seen him for 5 minutes. Okay, according to Mage, Skiff Miller had seen him for just five or some time. So, she said that yes, definitely you will hear him barking for the first time only, because you are here for just for about a minute or five, like that. Skiff Miller looked at her sharply, but his eyes were constantly stuck at Mitch. He meant something else. Okay. I thought you understood, he said slowly. I thought you understood that he's my dog. His name ain't Wolf, it's Brown. And while Skiff Miller saw, or he understood, that Walt and Mage have not understood that there is some meaning hidden, so he confirmed and he said very politely and clearly to them that I think you have not understood what I am trying to mean, but the truth is he is my dog, and since you are calling him Wolf, that is not Wolf, that is, his name is Brown. Okay. How do you know he is your dog? Walt demanded. And now Walt, because it is happening, no, that the pet is with me for such a long time, and someone has come from nowhere and he is saying that he is this dog is his. How can this happen? Nobody will believe this, na? So how do you know he is your dog? Walt demanded. You tell me, how can you say that he is your dog? Because he is, was the reply. Now, this thing is getting very interesting. The reply which Skiff Miller is giving there is very interesting, that he is saying that he is not giving any proof. If you see here, he is not giving any proof. Rather, he is saying that he is my dog. That is why he is my dog. What else do I say? He is, so he is. That is the thing. Skiff Miller is saying that he is my dog. But he is not giving any kind of proof to make Walt or Mage believe that he is actually my dog. Rather, he is just confirming the truth that he is my dog. I don't have to give you any proof for that. Skiff Miller turned to the dog. Brown, he called out. His voice rang out sharply, and at the sound, the dog's ears flattened down. Gee, the dog made a swinging turn to the right. And now, just a kind of sound when the master calls their pet, the kind of sound which the dog or the pets make, the same kind of sound was made by the dog also. And with that, we can confirm that, yes, this is the thing. The dog made a swinging turn to the right. Now, mush on. Mush on means now stop. Because he was moving round and rubbing his body. He was very delighted. He was very happy and all that. So now the master, the actual master, that means Skiff Miller, he ordered that stop. Now stop. And now see what was the reaction. And the dog ceased his swing abruptly. He was moving. Okay. Just he was moving in this way. And just at the moment when Skiff Miller said stop, he was moving and he just stopped. Okay, that is abruptly. And stared straight ahead, halting obediently at the command. Just as the pets obey their master, he behaved in the very same way. Skiff Miller smiled proudly. Because that was the reaction he would have, na? Because the dog did exactly what the master had said. So that felt very proud that, yes, see, I'm able to give you the proof that he is my dog. He was my lead dog. That means Keith Miller had many other dogs, so he was the leader of those dogs. But you are not going to take him away with you. Mage are tremendously. Now, they are also starting to actually believe that, yes, this dog might belong to Skip Miller. So, they were a little scared now because they have already got close to the dog, no? So, they were thinking that if this dog is now taken away, then what? So, she asks that, you are not going to take him, no? No, he won't. Walt announced in a determined voice. Perhaps you want to sell him. We can buy him. Whereas Walt said that no, he will definitely not take him because and he can sell him. We'll buy him. There is no problem. Skip Miller shook his head and said, I reckon there's nothing inside to prevent me taking the dog right here and now, and I ain't selling him. He said that he is my dog and I can see nothing which will stop me from taking my dog away with me. And this is definitely for sure that I'm not going to sell my dog. Okay, he made everything clear. That means he is going to take him also, he is not going to sell him also. Very clearly he said, indirectly he said that the dog is not going to stay with you. I'm going to take it away with me. But what about the dog? Mitch cried. Have you considered the dog? But while Skip Miller said about, he made his point clear. So on the other hand, Mitch was asking, what about the dog? He had stayed with us for this much time. What about him? If he feels close to us, what about him? If he wants to stay with us, have you thought about him? Skip Miller looked puzzled. Now he looked puzzled. Yes, the point was correct. Madge had some point in her words that yes, the dog had stayed for such a long time. He, the dogs, these animals, they also have their emotions. What if he wants to, what if the dog wants to stay with this Walt and Madge? What about that? Maybe the dog has some choice in the matter. Madge went on. Maybe he has his likes and dislikes. It has never entered your mind that possibly he would like to stay here and not go back? Yes, thing is correct. It might happen that he wants to stay here and not go back with you. This was a new way of looking at it, and Miller was clearly debating about it in his mind. And he also thought that yes, this point is correct. He might also have his likes and dislikes, and whatever will happen, he will have to surely respect that, because if he loves his dog, then obviously he'll do that, right? So we'll stop up to here. Let's see in our next class what happens. Only just a page is left. If I continue, then this video is going to be quite a long one. So we'll stop here, and I hope you have already marked the paragraphs which I have told you. So up to paragraph 40 we have stopped, and in the next class we'll continue, okay? So you read this up to this part, and the next questions which will be coming from this part, I'll give you later after you watch the video, okay? Thank you.